Well, you might remember from the previous video, I had to cut out part of the structure of the bulkhead. So I made a template, drawn around it. I'm going to cut that out. And it's going to replace that bit just there. See how that's going to fit. So just need to put a couple of holes in it for spot welds, and we'll be good to go. Hi folks, well, we're getting there slowly now, slowly but surely. I've tack welded the footwell in down the side. And I've just got the top to do, which is tomorrow's job. You can just about get this bit of flooring. It's I kind of anticipated having a bit of trouble. I need to just take a bit off the corner because the bolt holes don't line up at the moment. And you can see around this side, I've just started with the seam sealer, Halfords grey stripe seam sealer. Was recommended to me, and it seems to be pretty good stuff. Using a fair bit of it because I don't want to have the same trouble in just a few years. Hopefully it will last another 10 years at least. Particular trouble on the old one was this bit here, this part of the bulkhead, where water had got underneath it because it hadn't been sealed properly and it had rotted out from beneath. So hopefully that will stop that. Another little job I found to do is sort out the plug on the alternator. It looks fairly messy. And I don't like these bare wires here. Don't want them to short out on anything. Right, well that's going to be it for today's video, but looks like I found another job to do. That moves and the ball joint doesn't. I don't think that's quite right. I've tightened this up as much as I can. It still doesn't grip it. And there's a bit of play that way. So it might explain why the steering became a little bit vague. So we won't be going anywhere till that's done. So I'm going to replace all the ball joints. Make sure she's alright. hopefully after that, brakes, and then we'll do the springs. Now that's it for today, so I hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.